if you save $1 in your 20s, it actually becomes $24 when you are 65. For me, I cannot build deep friendship unless... Hey there, it's Ronnie here. Welcome to Big City Faith, a young people's guide to faith in a big city. In our last video, I shared 4 reasons why you should move to a big city. In fact, I made the case that if you are a Christian in the 21st century, I believe that we have a mandate to move to a big city. But living in a big city is a big trade-off. There are several downsides that may affect you quite severely, so you need to be well prepared. And that is why today I want to talk to you about 2 big city problems and how I dealt with it. Let's get started. The first problem is loneliness. Now I know this is very ironic given how many people live in a city, but unless you are intentional about meeting people and joining a community, it is actually much harder to develop natural relationships in a city, especially if you are a working professional. For a millennial in your 20s and 30s, you probably noticed by now that meeting friends after university gets much harder, especially if you try to meet them at work. It's not impossible, it's just much harder. Co-workers in a big city tend to live very far from each other, so it's hard to spontaneously meet up on weeknights or on weekends. For me, I cannot build deep friendship unless we have long-form conversation, and that only happens when we go for a walk together or take a ride together or, you know, visit each other's homes. Now, if you can't make good friends at work, you could probably try to meet your neighbors instead. But this is also harder in a big city as well. When you're in university or when you're in a small town, you see each other in daily life a lot more, and you would, you know, stop to have small talks. But in a big city, that's less common. People tend to be more private and mind their own business. If you're young and living by yourself in a big city, chances are you are probably living in a condo apartment. It's fancy, it's convenient, and it's more affordable. In fact, I did that for most of my 20s. But typically, we only see our neighbors when we are rushing out to work or when we are coming home from work. So we would say hi to each other, but unless you are intentional, opportunities to really get to know your neighbors are very far and in between. These are my experiences in a big city. If you have a different personality than mine, then you might not have these problems. But if you often feel lonely living in a big city, if you don't have the opportunities to develop deep friendship with people, then here is what I would suggest. You need to be intentional about this because it will not happen naturally. First of all, don't live by yourself, even if you can afford it. Get a roommate or live in a home with multiple tenants. Not only do you get to expand your social circle very quickly, but you can also save a lot of money. And secondly, find a group that meets regularly to do something that you're interested in. Maybe you like to play basketball, or maybe you like to draw, or maybe you like to read books and talk about it with people. But don't just sign up for any activities. You want to look for the ones that meets regularly and also has a consistent community behind it. And the reason is this: if you are not naturally an outgoing person, then you will need time to break into a group, right? So if the people who show up to an event is different every time, then it would actually be quite overwhelming and still very hard for you to make friends. Thirdly, whether you are religious or not, I would recommend that you join a local church to check it out. I'm not saying this just because I'm a Christian. I really think that there are good reasons why people in a church community tend to feel less lonely. It lets you meet regularly with like-minded people. If you are down for a deep and open conversation, if you're interested in figuring out the big questions in life, if you want to volunteer with other Christians to serve the local community, then you might actually like going to church, you know, even if you're not religious. Moreover, when you are new to a church, people go out of their way to make you feel welcome. They open up their friend group to welcome you. I actually don't know many social clubs that do this intentionally, because most of the time it is up to you to take initiatives to join the group. Now, you can say that Christians are doing this because they want to share their religion with you, and yes, that's true, but you don't have to do anything you don't want, right? So there is really no downside in my opinion. So if you want to plug into a local community, go check out a local church. Now before we talk about the second issue, if you enjoyed this video, please hit that like button for the YouTube algorithm. And also, if you are living in a big city right now, would you comment down below to share your experience with me? I would really love to hear back from you. The second problem with big city life is the high cost of living, of basically everything. This starts with a place to live, but it doesn't end there, right? Food is more expensive. Transportation is more expensive. Entertainment is more expensive. Even your car insurance is more expensive by several hundred dollars. This means that even though life in a big city can be exciting and convenient, unless you already make a lot of money in your 20s, you probably have to choose between living the life and saving for a house. And that's a very real trade-off for a big city. If you live in a smaller town, then life would probably be more comfortable. But in my opinion, living in a city and having this trade-off is absolutely worth it. But in order to make it work, it is crucial that you are very disciplined with your money the moment that you start working, the moment that you graduate from school. If you save $1 in your 20s, it actually becomes $24 when you are 65. But if you spend it on traveling, on food, on fancy condos and all that, and you delay saving this $1 until your 30s, then it will only grow to $11 when you are 65. And if you defer that even further, all the way until the 40s, then it will only be $5. You see the difference? This is called compound interest. That's the power of compound interest. And this means that there is a huge opportunity if you are young. It means that if you're willing to make sacrifices in your 20s, it will put you so far ahead of other people your age that it will be very hard for them to catch up later. All because they try to live their life in their 20s while you make the necessary sacrifice. Remember that you are not in a city to live a fancy life, right? You are here to accomplish things and to make a difference in society. So here's my advice to you. Give up the date night out. Give up your one-bedroom condo and get a roommate. And give up buying that new car that you wanted. I'm not saying don't enjoy those things in life. I'm just saying don't do it in your 20s because they will be much cheaper later in life. Work hard instead now and do it later. There you have it, guys. My top two challenges of living in a city and how to overcome them. Do you agree with this? Does any of them resonate? Or do you have anything else to add? Comment down below to let me know. And thank you for watching this video all the way until the end. I really appreciate your support. And if you found this video to be helpful, consider subscribing to our channel so you don't miss the latest discussion. And also, would you mind sharing it with other millennials who are living in a big city so that we can get the word out and help more people? Once again, thank you for your support, and I will see you next week.